Well, I'm Christian Labezin, founder and main actor of the XIPE organization. XIPE means expansion of company through innovation, people development, and process improvement. I'm mainly focusing on business model innovation and also focusing on small and medium-sized companies. Not only IT-oriented companies, because I also support companies in other fields like composite design, etc. Well, my company is a member of the OPIS organization, Open Platform for Engineering of Embedded Systems, with an IT2 project that was being launched 3 years ago, with the purpose to define complement set of activities to ensure a very long-term availability of the tools which have to be in open source form, but that's not enough. So the purpose of OPIS is to design the condition by which these tools will be available for the users on a very, very long period of time, namely 30 years, 40 years, even more. And what I'm doing in it, mainly helping the people to design the business models that will really support this long-term availability of tools. That means actually that you have to find way to get sustainable resources on a very long terms in order to support the committers, the technical engineers, and all the management activities as well that you need in order to support the tools in the same way that a proprietary editor, for instance, will support their tools. But on the contrary, you won't be based on a proprietary approach that can be closed at any time. A takeover, for instance, of the given company can close the support. We have been facing such situation many times in the past. So in the OPIS approach, this sustainable activity is to be carried out through specific business models for technology providers, business models for the OPIS, now Polarsis organization, because OPIS given birth to a Polarsis industrial working group inside the Eclipse community, inside the Eclipse Foundation, actually. And therefore, the definition of a wide set of business models is very key point for the achievement of the OPIS mission and OPIS goals. We have done quite exhaustive review of the existing business model in the open source community, because inside the OPIS project you have a lot, many different open source organizations that are working commercially in open source contexts, and so we have examples of what works and what doesn't work. That's very interesting to integrate all this shared knowledge. And what we have done actually is to define adaptations of current models to the specific needs of the Polarsis industrial working group. What is very important to understand is that Polarsis doesn't want to subside its activity to any existing technology supplier. The objective of Polarsis is to support the ecosystem, not to replace any player. So the really objective of the Polarsis industrial working group is to help the ecosystem to enhance the business and to help the end user to get better services. And we really think that the two objectives are complementary, doesn't oppose themselves, but are complementary. And the key point of the Polarsis business model is to achieve this goal, helping the service provider to enhance the business and helping end user to get better service from those technology providers. It's very important because what we know about the efficiency of the economy and mainly the goals of our end users in terms of embedded systems rely very strongly on the availability of very efficient tools. We have seen that very intensely in the aerospace activity. Now we see that very growing and gaining strong attraction from the automotive industry, and we see that in the future we'll have the same thing to happen in healthcare activity. So we see that tools and availability of tools, when I mean availability, that means you can really use tools, so you have all the support you need, not only the tool and a key on a website repository. It's really to be able to use efficiently the tool, yeah. And that will be really key to have very efficient solutions in terms of embedded systems in very key societal activities like healthcare tomorrow. And right now in automotive, I will be very happy to see that my car will be very efficient, safe, secure, etc. I'm not 100% sure that the case now. So a lot of things has to be done. And you need tools. You need very efficient tools to do that. I would like to have more and more users. End users, but also techno providers, service companies, etc. We already have many proposals to join Polarsys. We are in the launching phase, so that takes a bit, some time. But I think at the end of this current year, 2012, we'll have much more companies joining the Polarsys organization.